Hi everyone, this is Charmaine from Fantastic Crafts. I hope all of you are having a wonderful Monday. Today I have the special card tutorial that is a steampunk card. I'm so excited to share this card. This card is a rustic kind of a distressed look with bird cages and gears, and it is absolutely gorgeous. Not only that, but this is a pop-up card, which makes this card just wonderful and kind of takes it to another level. I am in love with this card, and I hope you guys will give this card a try and impress those around you with it as well. So over here I have another example of the same mechanism of this card. I really wanted to show this example of the another card I created with the same exact mechanism, just to show that you can create this card to be any look you want, so you can personalize it however you would like. To begin, I start with an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Then on the 11 inch side of the paper, I score at 2 3/4, 5.5, and 8 1/4. I move this cardstock counterclockwise and score at 4 1/4. Once those score lines are done, I'm going to be cutting that middle section out. I do it so you are able to see it better. Now I use my Cricut trimmer to cut that part off, but you can use a blade, scissors, or anything you have. It really doesn't matter, even a ruler with your little craft knife. Now when I did use my trimmer, I missed a few spots, so I just simply took some scissors and snipped that extra part off. Once I was done cutting that, I made sure I creased all my score lines and then also varnished them. Now it does not matter which way you do it, because it will fold how it's supposed to be when you do this second part, which is just kind of playing with it, just kind of bending it until it comes to shape of an A2 size card. Once it folds into place, make sure you varnish this card really well. This helps make sure that the card is able to open and close very easily without any trouble. Now once again, this next part can be done with any crafting machine you have. I use my Cuddlebug to cut a rectangular shape onto one part of this card panel. So when you fold this in half with the slit side going to the side, you will see that there are two panels, each having two layers. So one of those panels with two layers, you are going to cut a shape of your choice. I chose rectangular shape. So as you can see over here, that's what I cut out. And then I had these two windows, one going to the left and one going to the right. Now we have the base of the card complete. So now we're going to move on to the mechanism. To create the mechanism, you're going to be cutting a cardstock piece 3 3/4 by 3 inches. Then you're going to be taking that cardstock and scoring it on the 3 3/4 inch side at 1/2 inch on each side. We then are going to be creating little strips with this scored piece of cardstock. So we're going to be cutting these at 1/4 inches. So each strip will be 1/4 inches, and you are going to be creasing those score lines and varnishing them very, very well again, so the mechanism can work well. And then you're going to be taking one of those folded crease part, and you're going to put it on the bottom of this card base, and you're going to line all these strips up until you have all four of the strips glued on. Then you're just going to make sure to see that none of the flaps are overlapping the score lines. This is the most important part. If you have any of the tabs overlapping the score lines, then the mechanism will be a little difficult to open and close. So to prevent that, I just trimmed a few little parts off just to make sure it doesn't overlap in any spot. Then I folded the other side of the flaps over, and then I closed my card base onto those flaps or that mechanism. Then I also put some glue on the sides of this card so the card can be completely closed down, and Then you have your mechanism and your card completed. This was the hardest part of this card. Now is the designing part. I know this video is getting rather long, so to save time, I decided to die cut all my pieces of the steampunk, the gears and the birdcage, anything, whatever you're making your theme into. I just decided to cut all those dies out off camera. Then I cut my mats out, and I decided to just have like a very slight 1/8 inch of a border, so that's what I used my mat for, and I wanted to use the colors red and silver just to kind of go with that metallic, that rustic and vintage look of a steampunk card. That's exactly what I was going for. So I used this Tim Holtz gears die set, and I cut out these little borders and I put it onto the sides of my card on slate colored cardstock. As you can see, this gives such an amazing look. I am in love with this die set. It's just amazing how the gears look. Tim Holtz has done it again with this die set. Now, like any step card, you want to build height. And with gears and bird cages, it's not a lot of height that is added. So how to add height, I just simply glued different gears on top of each other, and that created height. And then I used this iZinc pigment ink, and I just coated most of my gears with that color. And that just really brought out the gear look. It gave it that metallic, nice golden look. And then the next part is just simply decorating. And I'm not the best at this. I know you guys could do so much better with this card. So for this next part, I simply just cut out a ton of the gears and bird cages with my die cutting machine. And then I glued some together to, again, build height. And some I just left without doing anything, just putting the iZinc pigment ink, and then I just glued it all together to just kind of give it more of a uniform to look all over those steps of my card. Now for this part, there was no rhyme or reason. I just simply played. I placed the gears wherever I felt it needed a gear, or wherever I thought it was missing a spot. This is definitely the part of the card where you just play and create your own look and add your own character. I think with this kind of a card, you spend a lot of time with the mechanism and you know, doing a lot of measuring and all that. So definitely use this part to relax and just be you and use your creativity and go wild. I did add a few little extra detail to this card that I did want to talk about, like this bird cage. This is actually not a die that I had. I had a embossing folder by Tim Holtz again. And actually, I don't think it was by Tim Holtz. I just had a off-brand little birdcage embossing folder. And I used that, and then I just cut it out, and it's not my favorite, I know, but I just did it for this card. And I just added it to my card. And I did the same thing with the iZinc. I coated it just to give it that metallic look. Another little touch I added was these little, with my gel pen, I added some little strings, so it seems like the birdcage is hanging down. Then I took my iZinc, and I didn't like how stark white that border was, so I took my iZinc pigment ink once again, and I just kind of blotted it all over that frame to give it more like, you know, a kind of vintage look of paint splattering all over with the gears. I thought it really added some nice texture and dimension, another layer of dimension to this card. I did it on that some of those gears too, just to give the gears a more finished look. Then I went ahead and put it on that white as well, and it really looked really neat because it really looked like gold paint splattered all over the walls. I kind of want a room with this theme because I really, really liked it. So I went ahead and did that on the cover of the card as well, just to give it more of an uniform look. And that pretty much completes my card. I didn't put any sentiment. I really didn't think this card needed anything else. It is gorgeous the way it is. I'm so in love with this card and the style of card, and I want to create so many different things. The possibilities are definitely endless with this card, because you can go with any theme, anything, and it will be a gorgeous card no matter what. I really do hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, make sure you like this video, and if you haven't already, subscribe and hit that bell button to get notified of any new videos that I come up with. Thank you to my new subscribers, and all my subscribers actually, for supporting me in this little journey of YouTubing. Until next time, bye.